Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Clinic. So in this post we are going to see installation of NS2.35 in Windows 10 or Windows 11 operating system. So many students and many scholars are asking me about sir, how to install this NS2 on Windows 10 or 11. So I suggest them to go for NS3 as it is new and there are updates, there bug patches, all these things are available. Every 6 months they release. But some of them are still using NS2 for their older and older software libraries. So for them, so if you don't want to use Ubuntu, so then Windows 10 you can use it. So before that, please subscribe to my channel. So my channel have there are more than 100 videos that contains free source codes, as well as it will give an explanation, a full video explanation available for vehicular networks, Internet of Things, then NS2, NS3, like that. So in this video, let's go into the video. So in this video, we will be seeing the Windows subsystem for Linux. So actually, we are not installing directly in Windows 10, but Windows recently have announced a system for Linux called as Windows subsystem for Linux. So that means without the need of VMware or any hypervisor, we can right away install Linux within our Windows operating system so that the same memory, RAM processing will be used from that. So in this post, we'll be seeing how we can able to install NS2 on Windows 10 operating system. So before that, if you want to use WSL, please go through this link. It is my blog and I have a video link also there. So you can click the video link for the complete instruction of WSL. Please remember, only after installing WSL, you can able to install NS2 within it. So your step one is this and NS all-in-one 2.35.r.gz. So click this follow link and you can download the software. Okay, so now first thing is I have downloaded, and one more requirement is you need to have gcc-4.8 and g++-4.8 for NS2.35. The reason being NS2.35 is very old software. The last patch is around 2011, almost 10 years ago. So we need GCC 4.8 and G++ 4.8. So that will be available only in Ubuntu 18.04. So we need to install 18.04 packages also. Okay. So the first thing here is, so this is my blog. I already have this here. So first what I need to do is I need to open this apt-sources.list. So step one. So step one is open command prompt. Or PowerShell. So in Windows you can open the command prompt or PowerShell. So let me go with the command prompt. So this is the command prompt. So I'll make the font bigger. Let me use 28. Okay, fine. So 28. Now I use WSL. The command is WSL. So this is the WSL command. Okay, so now from C colon it's I need to use WSL, then it will be creating a prompt here. Okay. So now I am in this folder, mount C users TS Pradeep Kumar. So TSPRA. Now I have downloaded the software in this downloads. So in this downloads, in the downloads, I have the software NS all-in-one 2.35.r.gz. Actually, this folder is for Windows. I need to move this folder to Linux. So what do I do is, so what I do is I got this, move the ns-all-in-one-2.35.r.gz file to Linux. So Linux means in this folder /home/Pradeep Kumar. So in your case, whichever username you have in this folder, you have to move. So what I do is I'll be using this command cp ns-all-in-one-2.35.r.gz/home/Pradeep Kumar. So once I give this command, the file will be moved. Okay. So now, so this is the command I have just used. Okay. So now check this command cd and press enter. So then you can check pwd. Okay. So cd and pwd. So I am in this folder now. Then use ls and check it. So my file is available here. NS all in one 2.35.r.gz, which is available here. Okay, so You just try out ls now and check the file is available. So every time I need to use it, I'll just copy this now. For time being, I'll copy this. Okay, so now what I do is I need to unzip it. So unzip or untar the file. So tar zxvf ns all-in-one 2.35.tar.gz. This is the command to untar or unzip. So tar zxvf ns all-in-one 2.35.tar.gz. Okay, it's done. So I have unzipped. So this is a file I have unzipped. It becomes a folder now. Okay, so now we'll go for gcc hyphen 4.8 and g++ hyphen 4.8 installation. So for that, what we have to do is sudo etc apt sources dot list. Okay, so in this sudo etc apt sources dot list. Sorry, I need to use an editor and nano. So give the password. So the command here is sudo nano. Nano is the name of the editor. So you can see at the end, I have already added it. So this is the line I have added here. So this is the line you need to add. So add the following line, the above file. So we need to add this following line. So this is the line that I have added. So Bionic is the name of Ubuntu 18.04. So that I need to add it. Whereas Focal will be the name for 20.04. So Bionic is for 18.04. Okay, so then I need to use sudo apt update. So once it is done, now the Bionic also will be updated. You can see Bionic also updated and Focal also updated. So both 20.04 and 18.04 libraries will be updated. So then we can use the command sudo apt update. Okay, so it is done. So next thing is sudo apt install gcc hyphen 4.8 then g++ hyphen 4.8. Now I need to do that. Already I have installed, so that's why it is showing this message. So you can use this command sudo apt install gcc hyphen 4.8 and g++ hyphen 4.8. So both packages have to be installed. Okay, so now that is done. So once it is done, then we have unzipped and the packages also be installed. Now we need to do some changes. So let me take those changes. So I have these changes here. So modify the following make files. So I need to do these changes here. So this seems to be a complicated process, but this is the only way that you can able to use within Windows. Okay, so now GCC 4.8 and G++ 4.8 will be used for NS2. This is the latest package that it will useful for NS2, and we have done that. But in the makefile, generally it gives GCC. It gives simply GCC. So GCC means you can check it here. GCC hyphen version. When you try it, will show you 9.3. So 9.3 version will never be used, or it doesn't use. NS2 does not know how to handle 9.3 version of GCC. So we have to change in NS2 packages, in all the places we have to change it to GCC hyphen 4.8 or G++ hyphen 4.8. So which are the locations? So in the NS2.35 makefile, then in NAM1.15 makefile, then xgraph makefile.in and otcl makefile.in. In all these locations we have to change at cc at to gcc 4.8, then at cxx at to g++ 4.8. similarly at cpp at or also we have to change it to g++ hyphen 4.8. so be specific and see the spelling. You should not change the spelling, else it will throw an error. So first let me go into cd ns all in one, then I'll use this command nano's editor ns2.35/makefile.in. So this is the makefile.in. So once you go to CC, you can see there are CC equal to add CC app. So GCC hyphen 4.8. Then this will be changed to G++ hyphen 4.8. So first change is done. So after the change is done, see for exit, Control X. Save modified buffer, yes or no. Click yes. Then enter. That's it. The file is saved. Then again nano OTCL. Makefile.in. Now in this case, here I have CC here. So in the CC here, change it to GCC hyphen 4.8. Then check it for G++. Okay, so there is no GCC. And save yes, click yes. So next thing is nano. Xgraph actually no change it. Xgraph might throw some error. So we have a separate method for Xgraph compilation. You can do that. We already have a video in my channel. You can try with that. So now we have, I think yes, CC is there. So CC we have GCC hyphen 4.8 and CPP we have G++ hyphen 4.8. Control X, Y, enter. Then nano, one more place, nam 1.5 makefile.in. Now in this folder also we have to make a change. Yeah, two changes here. So GCC hyphen 4.8, then G++ hyphen 4.8. So what I do is, in case we want to replace these files, I'll give the entire folder. You can use that folder and then just copy paste that. So that way you can do that. Okay, so now it is done. So now one more changes we have to do. So what change is that is, so in this file ns3.2.35 link state ls.h, in this folder void erase all, erase here you have to use, instead of erase you have to make it this dot erase. So this thing you have to give. So nano ns link state ls.h in this folder, sorry, in this file, you go to line number 137. Yeah, here void. So in this erase you can give it to this dot erase. Control X, Y, enter. So now we have done all the changes. So all changes are made. All the changes have been made. Now go to the terminal. Use dot slash install. So dot slash install. So now installation going on. So after the installation is over, it will show the path. It will show the path information once the installation is complete. So those files have to be edited. So let us see in the video. So now the installation is successful. You can see here it shows you NS all in one package have been installed successfully. Okay, so now we have to set the path. So now this, please put up till here in the path environment. So copy this. Now sudo, what we have to do is we have to go to the home folder. Okay, so nano dot bash rc, enter. So here somewhere here, paste it, and then so we have to use a path like this, export path equal to dollar path, colon. So first thing is done. So again we'll go back, Control X, Y, yes. So then you save it now. So again one more time, this will be copied from here to here. LD library path, LD underscore library underscore path, again you write it. So export LD underscore library underscore path equal to. So then we have a comma. Instead of a comma, we have to use a colon. The file separator is a colon. That's it. After that, control X, press Y, and enter. So that means we have saved it. Now to run this bash rc, either you can restart the machine or you can directly use source.bashrc. So once it is done, ns. So once it is ns, you can see here the percentage indicates that the ns to install successfully. Control C. Then nam. So once I type nam, so nam is a gui. We need a gui. So anyway, gui is not there. So you can check my video for installing a WSL, that is Windows subsystem for Linux. It comes with the GUI also. In case if you have a GUI, then NAM will be popped out. Okay, so NS installed successfully. So now the command here is update the path information to the file called .bashrc. So open the file using this command nano slash home slash Pradeep Kumar .bashrc. So then let me copy these two lines. So this is the file that we can so this is a complete file that we have copied here. Anyway, I'll just share the file in my then after it is done, you have to use the command source.bashrc. Then check for ns and percentage indicates ns to installed successfully. Okay. So now I will give the entire thing in GitHub. So github.com/ Pradeep Kumar. Okay, I will give ns to here. So this in this repository, I will give all the files. Download from this repository. Okay. So that's all. So thanks for watching my video. So please subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.